our Aspen Aero brand is a global brand in the future.
It's fully electric, eco-friendly, and even flies on its own with the help of built-in AI. From the luxurious, spacious interior to the aerodynamic exterior designed for smooth flying, Dubai is taking a huge step into the future with the release of its first ever flying car. Not only does it look amazing, but the technology is next level too. So, stay with us until the end to know more about it. This is not just a regular car that can somehow lift off the ground. It's a fully electric vehicle designed specifically to fly using vertical takeoff and landing technology, also known as VTOL. If you've ever seen a helicopter take off, you know how VTOL works. But unlike helicopters, which can be pretty loud and bulky, this flying car is sleek, quiet, and much more eco-friendly because it runs on electricity. The flying car is powered by advanced electric engines, which not only makes it better for the environment, but also quieter and more efficient. One of the most impressive parts is the autonomous flying system. You don't need to be an experienced pilot to use this thing. The flying car comes with built-in artificial intelligence, AI, that handles most of the flying for you. You just tell it where you want to go, and it takes you there while avoiding obstacles and other flying vehicles. The car's technology doesn't stop at flying, though. It's loaded with smart connectivity features, meaning it's always in touch with the surrounding city infrastructure. This connectivity ensures that the flying car stays aware of other flying vehicles, buildings, and even weather conditions. It's like a highly intelligent drone that's constantly updating its route to keep you safe and on time. This flying car also has built-in safety systems. Think of things like collision avoidance technology, backup batteries, and emergency landing protocols. If anything goes wrong, the car knows how to safely get you back to the ground. The whole design has been thought through, not just to be futuristic and cool, but to make flying cars practical and safe for everyday use. The design is sleek, modern, and totally futuristic, which makes sense because it's not just meant to get you from point A to point B. It's meant to do it in style. The car is built with aerodynamics in mind, meaning its shape is optimized for flying smoothly through the air with as little resistance as possible. It's got a kind of sporty yet elegant look, making it stand out whether it's on the ground or in the sky. Inside, the flying car is all about luxury and comfort. The seats are likely to be plush and comfortable, with plenty of legroom because when you're flying, space is a bit easier to come by. The dashboard won't look anything like what you see in cars today. It's more like a high-end cockpit. Everything is controlled through touchscreens and voice commands, and you'll have all the information you need, like your altitude and speed, displayed digitally. Some standout features include smart connectivity, so your flying car is always connected to your phone, smart home, or other devices. It's also designed to be eco-friendly, using sustainable materials inside the car. And because safety is a priority, there are features like collision avoidance, automatic landing systems, and even backup engines in case something goes wrong. You'll feel safe knowing the car can handle emergencies on its own. On the outside, the design is aerodynamic, which helps reduce drag and makes the car more efficient in the air. The doors are designed to open upward, similar to luxury sports cars, but here it serves a practical purpose, making it easier to get in and out in tight spaces or when parked next to other flying vehicles. The car's exterior is built to be lightweight but durable, with a focus on both performance and safety. Not only will flying cars make commuting faster, but they'll also make it more efficient. By taking some of the traffic off the streets and putting it in the air, roads could be less crowded, meaning even those still driving on the ground might get around faster. It's a win-win situation for urban mobility. Flying cars are also better for the environment, especially since Dubai's version is electric. That means zero emissions, which is a big step toward reducing the city's carbon footprint. It's not just about convenience, it's about making cities cleaner and greener. Flying cars could also eventually be integrated into public transportation systems, allowing people to share rides, reducing the number of vehicles in the air, and making the whole system more sustainable. Looking further ahead, flying cars could make it possible to rethink how cities are designed. Without the need for as many roads and highways, urban planners could focus more on green spaces, pedestrian areas, and other elements that improve the quality of life. Flying cars might seem like a small change at first, but they have the potential to revolutionize how we live and move within cities. With the arrival of flying cars in Dubai, one of the biggest challenges is figuring out how to manage air traffic, You can't just have everyone flying around without some rules in place, right? This isn't like driving on the ground where you have stoplights and road signs. In the air, things get a bit more complex, so Dubai's government is already working on new regulations and airspace management systems to ensure that everything runs smoothly and, most importantly, safely. First, there's the question of airspace. Unlike regular airplanes that fly thousands of feet above the ground, flying cars will operate at much lower altitudes, probably between the heights of tall buildings and helicopters. This means that new air routes will need to be established to avoid collisions between flying cars, helicopters, drones, and other air traffic. Dubai is known for its forward-thinking approach, and they're already working on integrating these flying cars into a larger network of air traffic control systems. These systems will use advanced technologies like GPS tracking, AI, and even 5G to monitor and guide flying vehicles, making sure everyone stays safe and on course. But it's not just about technology. There will also be regulations around who can fly these vehicles. It's likely that pilots, or even passengers, if the cars are autonomous, will need a special license, just like you need a driver's license for a car. The government will have to set strict rules about when and where flying cars can take off and land, how they interact with other air traffic, and what happens in case of emergencies. Now, you might be wondering, who gets to use these flying cars? Are they just for the super rich, or could you and I hop in one for a quick trip across the city? Right now, it seems like flying cars in Dubai will be accessible to both personal and commercial users. So, while they might start off being more of a luxury item, the goal is to make them part of everyday life for regular people as well. For personal use, owning a flying car might be like owning a high-end electric vehicle today. It's a status symbol, but also a practical mode of transport. In the beginning, it's likely that only those with deep pockets will be able to afford them. But as the technology evolves and becomes more mainstream, prices could come down. The good news is, Dubai is aiming to make these vehicles available for tourists and everyday commuters eventually, perhaps as part of a ride-sharing or rental service. On the commercial side, we might see flying cars used for things like air taxis or even deliveries. Uber and other companies have already been exploring this, and Dubai's flying car could be the first step in making that dream a reality. Commercial use could also include things like emergency services, where flying cars could be used to transport medical supplies or even act as rapid response vehicles. So, how the flying car will impact Dubai's economy? Dubai is already a global hotspot for tourists, thanks to its luxury hotels, futuristic architecture, and incredible attractions. Flying cars will add another reason for people to visit. This will give Dubai a unique selling point, drawing in even more visitors who want to see the future of transportation firsthand. Then there's the business side. The flying car industry itself will create jobs, from engineers and designers to technicians and pilots. But it doesn't stop there. Flying cars will need infrastructure, like landing pads, maintenance hubs, and air traffic control systems, which will create even more jobs and stimulate sectors like construction, IT, and services. Plus, as flying cars become more common, new industries could spring up around them. For example, companies specializing in flying car rentals, air taxis, or even flying car tours of the city. Another big factor is foreign investment. Dubai has always been a magnet for international companies, and the introduction of flying cars will only strengthen its position as a leader in innovation. Tech companies from around the world will want to be part of this new market, setting up offices in Dubai and investing in the city's future. This influx of investment will boost Dubai's economy and help it maintain its status as a global tech hub. Flying cars are a key part of Dubai's vision for becoming a fully connected, smart city. A smart city is one that uses technology and data to improve the quality of life for its residents, making things like transportation, energy, and communication more efficient. Flying cars fit perfectly into this model because they're not just a new form of transport. They're designed to integrate seamlessly into the city's smart infrastructure. Dubai has already been working on building smart roads, smart traffic lights, and smart public transport systems. These systems are all interconnected, meaning they can talk to each other and adjust based on real-time data. For example, smart traffic lights can change their timing based on the number of cars on the road, making traffic flow more smoothly. Flying cars will be part of this network too, interacting with these systems to ensure they fly safely and efficiently around the city. One of the most exciting aspects of flying cars in smart cities is how they'll communicate with other vehicles and the city itself. For instance, the flying car will be connected to a central network that monitors traffic in the air and on the ground. This network will tell the car where it's safe to fly, help it avoid obstacles, and even choose the fastest route to your destination. This level of connectivity is what will make flying cars not only possible, but practical in a busy urban environment like Dubai. As exciting as flying cars are, they come with their own set of challenges that need to be addressed before they become a common sight in the sky. One of the first challenges is cost. Right now, the technology behind flying cars is still relatively new, which makes them expensive to produce. This means that, at least in the beginning, flying cars will likely be out of reach for most people, reserved for the wealthy or as part of luxury services. Over time, as more companies get involved and the technology becomes more widespread, the cost may come down. But for now, affordability is one of the biggest barriers to flying cars becoming mainstream. Another challenge is battery life and range. While these flying cars are electric, battery technology still has limitations. Just like electric cars on the road, flying cars need powerful batteries to operate. The issue is that current battery technology may not yet provide enough power for long flights without recharging. This means that the range of flying cars might be limited, at least for the first few years. Engineers are working on improving battery efficiency, but it's a challenge that needs to be solved before flying cars can fully replace ground transportation. Safety is another critical factor. Flying cars need to be absolutely safe for people to trust them. Let me know in the comments what you think. Would you want to take a ride in one of these? And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future updates.